The Aussie Angus Deluxe is back at Macca's. Available after 10:30 a.m. for a limited time.
Beamed from Black Mountain. Around our nation's capital. Live from a dingy, dark box situated in a crace paddock next to the sheep. This is... Wilco.
Well, good morning to you, Courtney.
Hello, how are you?
Good, thank you. It's a fun mum shirt.
Is it?
Yeah.
It's a mum shirt.
It looks a little bit like those placemats that Nan had, plastic ones.
Why do you have to ruin nice things? It's a nice shirt. It's cool.
It is nice. I'm just saying it looks, I think that's in now.
Okay, Nan's placemats.
Placemats. You know,
right.
The plastic ones that had like weird art on them?
Yeah.
And you're like, what is that? And you're like, oh, I think it's a it's a bowl.
I'm sure the designer of this shirt would be glad to know you think they make weird art.
I think they might. Morning, Sammy.
Good morning, Wilko. How are you?
Great, thank you. I'm a bit unhinged today and I'm excited about it. Hayley, you well?
I am well. How are you?
I'm good, thank you. So Sammy's dressed as if she's going to host some sort of function today. Courts is dressed as if she's a placemat. And you were dressed like a PE teacher.
Yeah, I am giving PE teacher.
Is it the vest?
I think it's the vest.
I'm wearing a HIT branded vest because I'm a company man.
Of course.
And then, of course, you've got your lanyard and your big glasses.
And my whistle.
Oh, good. You brought the whistle today.
Hello, bitch.
Keep him in line.
Yes. Also, it is a big happy birthday. To Harry Styles, you either want to be with him or be him.
Or both.
Or both, in my case. So it's dealer's choice today. You get to pick for his 30th birthday. Do you want Falling, Golden, Watermelon Sugar, As It Was, or Adore You? Go.
Golden.
Golden?
Yeah.
Golden?
Yes.
Oh, Sammy doesn't even know who Harry Styles is by the look of her face.
What are you...
You got me off guard.
We'd pick a song. It's not that hard, mate. It's not that... Anyway, 30 today. What do we think he's doing?
Tradies themed dress up party.
Yes. Guys, we're going to go to the pub. Going down the alley. Yeah. Just like.
Just the vest, no shirt.
Don't worry. I put $900 on the bar tab. So you'll all get like 3 rounds. It'll be great. Somebody in the show is regretting their choice of Harry Styles songs, but that's your fault, Hayley. If you didn't speak up and say you wanted Falling, you missed out.
It's just so sad. And I don't know if we should start the show on such a sad note.
I know. It's for his birthday.
Yeah.
Maybe he's a sad boy.
Well, he definitely
is.
There you go. We know that.
Thanks for joining us this morning. I get to start the show.
What a prestigious... you were really upset about it just then. You just were screaming, just can't I just push the buttons? Why do I have to bring the talk topics? Why do I have to talk?
I get it, guys. Very famous. One of the tradies here yesterday, little cutie that he is, was just sort of, it was in the office because they're like ripping out walls and stuff and whatever. We're doing a reno on a budget. And we were talking about my name being Neil because it's just a hot topic at all times.
Yeah.
And the tradie was like, I just thought your name was Wilko.
Imagine that. Imagine going through labor and then being like, I'm going to call him Wilko Wilcock.
I think there's more sense in that than calling him Neil. I need to talk to you about this caseworker who is working with a lot of different people, families, and also people who are just getting out of prison and trying to get their life back together. This caseworker has made a huge boo-boo, and I don't even know if it's a joke, but it's happening in New Zealand. This caseworker has said to a guy called Sanjay that he was in... prison in Auckland for 2 years because he was a drug runner. He has done a lot of rehabilitation and he's back out. And he's finding it very hard to get a job and also to get housing. And he's trying very hard. But the caseworker said, I don't know what to tell you.
Okay. That's not what their job is.
Yeah. You're meant to help get jobs and keep the rehabilitation. People do bad things.
Yeah.
By degrees.
Yeah.
But obviously...
Work with them. Give them options.
People make mistakes. the caseworker just said, and I quote, maybe just go rob a bank.
Is it that the sarcasm hasn't translated?
I don't know. There's a transcript of the conversation because the conversations are recorded.
Oh, no.
Because he said, because he's living in his car at the moment because he cannot get a place to live.
Yeah.
And he said, at least in jail, I had a place to live.
Yeah. Oh.
Which is
so the caseworker is implying, like, do something that gets you back in jail.
Yeah.
Oh, that's sad. Oh, this is not, I don't know how, this is sad.
Yeah, I know. I know. Hey, if you want me to start the show.
Should have played Falling.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Just all be sad boys.
Canberrans love a loud bang.
Oh, hey, did anyone hear that bang? Palmerston. Did anyone hear that bang? Canberra.
People will write about it on Reddit. They'll write about it on the Canberra Notice Board group. They'll write about it just anywhere they possibly can online.
I'm pretty sure it was machine guns.
Someone's blowing up fireworks. No, no, it's the back of someone's car. Yeah. You're in Tuggeranong.
Yeah.
You're going to hear it all night long. I can say that. I live there.
And so, I can also say, Gungahlin, what a place.
So, a lot of loud bangs happening around the capital. I want to play a loud bang.
Oh, great.
And see if
this... Was it from here?
This is not from here.
Well, because you can never really record them. They're such a mystery. So
yeah. This is a loud noise that's happening somewhere. This is in Florida. And I want to see what the Canberrans in us would think it was. Hayley? Well, oh, you already know.
I know.
You
I
already
know. What it
know.
Is.
Sammy?
It sounds like something in a womb. Like that's what it reminds me of. Yeah. Like an alien or
I'm
something.
I'm going to lock in mating.
Oh, you got it.
Did I?
Yeah.
Watch a lot of Attenborough.
The residents of Tampa, Florida are being kept up at night by this noise, this thumping sort of noise. Yeah. It's quite alien-esque, yeah. Isn't it? People have been wondering, probably on their version of the Canberra Notice Board group, they've been wondering, what is this noise? Where is it coming from? And as it turns out, it is a black drum fish, and they tend to mate on winter nights, and apparently it is making this echoing kind of noise from the ocean, keeping up the residents of Tampa.
Wow, they're just really...
doing it.
Yeah, just getting it on.
I've heard people say that.
No?
I don't know about that.
Do you think? Do you think this is still the song of choice?
Well, you're not rocking Barry White.
No.
Okay. I'll stop then at home.
Aussie tradies are mad. Yeah, there's plenty of Canberran tradies about already.
Are they mad because we're about to get close to winter again?
And I mean, that would be hard, wouldn't it?
I guess as a tradie, you just get either ends of the stick. You either get it being too hot.
Yeah.
Or because the tradies I was making friends with yesterday.
you love getting masked with a tradie.
Yeah, and other things with tradies. But we were having just a little chit-chat about, because I said, oh, don't worry about the terrible building.
Yeah.
And I said, if a fire starts, let it go. And probably should have said that on there.
No, I wouldn't.
Okay. Oh, well, I didn't start the fire. I'm just saying don't put it out. They said, yeah, you know, it's a pretty rubbish building. But he said it's way better than being outside in the middle of
in the heat
or the cold.
And there's been like a lot of tradies who are having to like lay new asphalt and stuff, and you're seeing them out in the
hot days,
sweltering.
Yeah.
But apparently tradies in Australia are just not putting in the hard yakka, as Tomo, the tradie, has told news.com.au. It all adds up, what Tomo's
saying. Is his name Tom and you've made it Tomo?
No, it's listed as Tomo.
I love it.
In the article, and he's the one who said the hard yakka. So Tomo has said that the apprentice tradies, he doesn't even bother with them now because of their work boundaries, a.k.a. the young people. They have their boundaries about what they're willing to do on the job.
Okay. Now, when we're saying boundaries, we're not asking them to do things that are above and beyond their job.
No, I think they're just asking them to do tradie type things,
right,
which generally means getting your hands and your feet and the rest of your body pretty dirty.
Yeah, sure.
And wearing a bit of high vis.
But that's why there's a premium, you know what I mean, to pay tradies.
Because
it's hard work. And
yeah, it is. Absolutely.
A bunch
hard
of people
work.
Don't want to do it, so you've got to pay more for the people who want to.
He is saying that he's struggling to secure talent. And Tomo's not old, by the way. He's 38. Like, he's not like some 60-year-old man, like, yelling from the roof and saying, why don't you just get up here and put the tiles on yourself? This is like, he's just saying that anyone in that younger generation, like around the 20s, which is when you would start an apprenticeship, they're just saying he is struggling to secure talent. Young workers can get away with a lot more than they used to.
Yeah.
I guess they're just not as willing to get a bit rough.
But even in every sector.
In every sector.
Like, I've got people, friends who own businesses, and they just are always like, I can't get them to do stuff.
Well, he said that there was one young guy that he'd hired that you couldn't get him out of bed. One day he went to the front door and actually had to take him out of the bed to get to work.
No.
So he's not even on the job yet, and he's like,
imagine if Rod, our boss, had to physically come and grab me out of bed.
Imagine if I had to come get me, Murray Bateman to Caldwell.
Oh, what a trek.
The drive.
You know what I'm hearing, though? I'm hearing we're irreplaceable. Us millennials.
Oh, okay, sure.
So
we're still hardworking, but we also like respect people and their lives.
Yes.
So
and that
like,
means so when people look at our birthdays, and they go, is that a cuspy? No, definitely a millennial.
Yeah.
People
we
are
can still hire
us.
Them. Yeah.
Great.
And like, no,
this
offense.
Is excellent. Sucks for Tomo.
Oh yes,
but this is great for us, and I love
you. Could be a tradie.
I've got the gift of the gab with them. That's what I found out over the last couple of days. This is, let's just come with me.
Whoa.
Come with me as I try to explain this story to you. So hands up in the room if you went to a school that had like a religious denomination. Okay, all of us.
Yeah.
So when I was younger, I went to a public school, and then sort of in year eight, at the end of year eight, went to a private school because this posh boy was getting bullied too much.
Mm.
I'm posh boy, in case you didn't know. Mother. So I understand that when you go to a school that has a religious denomination, you would have a chaplain of sorts there.
Yes.
Somebody who is there, and you have to go to maybe, we had to do the church every morning. We had to do mass every morning.
The church.
The church.
Yeah.
I also call it the Facebook, so don't be offended. And it's not for me. Religion's not for me. I'm a little bit obsessed with religions. I love watching documentaries on them.
Yeah.
And I don't watch, you know, religious documentaries if it's turned out well. You know what I mean? Like, there's
like
no,
everyone's happy and living harmoniously.
No one's like, this is actually the best religion ever.
Yeah.
Which I don't know if you could actually point one out. But anyway, in Iowa, there has been a House subcommittee only on Tuesday this week that has tried to pass a bill that would allow chaplains in schools that don't have denominations.
Okay.
So even if you're not a Catholic school or an Anglican school or whatever, you might have a chaplain there, and the chaplain could be from any denomination.
Okay, so it's for unreligious schools bringing in a religious person, right?
And you can apply as a chaplain to go there and be the chaplain of the school. It would be a position that would be opened, and schools can either choose to have or not have.
They're going to be like if it was a Catholic chaplain and they just went into like a public school and they were like counselling the kids for whatever reason, do you think they'd like be trying to get them into the church?
Maybe.
Yeah.
I guess it's some sort of indoctrination. Maybe. I'm not sure. I don't want to. Religious, it's tricky. It's tricky because everyone believes different things.
Yes.
And that's okay.
That's
and I'm
cool.
not a, you believe whatever you want to believe. Just because I don't believe it, that's fine. I don't believe in Satan, just like I'm not really into God.
Yeah.
Hayley?
So you don't believe in yourself?
Okay.
Got him.
And I don't believe in myself. but there is the head of the Satanic Temple of Iowa has come out and spoken, because Satanic temples also have chaplains.
Oh, okay. Send him in.
Well, it's quick of you to do that. Here's a direct...
It's called equality.
A direct quote from the Satanic Temple from their press release said, if the bill does pass, I'm excited for the opportunities it presents for the Satanic Temple to provide support services and programs to school children in our state. Mortimer, I don't know that last name, a minister of Satanic Temple said, Iowa had several ordained ministers of Satan and they would be happy to engage with children.
Is the Satanic Temple, do they worship Satan or do they denounce
that's
Satan?
That's their deity, yeah.
Is there a Satanic Temple here?
I don't know.
The Canberra clergy of Satanic Temples. Yeah.
I'm sure they listen.
Yeah, probably.
Because if you play Ed Sheeran backwards.
Oh, yeah. Oh, you nearly
I missed it. The other day I was too early.
Yeah.
Do it now.
What? Hit 104.7. It's Wilco and Courts. Your new way to wake up.
Just devastating news out of Sydney.
Right.
It's been hot. And that's because it's summer in Australia, in case you're wondering. And there was a Woolworths store in Bondi specifically that the air conditioning could not keep up, and all the chocolate started melting on the shelves. Can you imagine?
I can't imagine.
You couldn't even, you couldn't chuck it in the freezer and let it re-harden because it goes white. Like it all turns a weird white colour. Mm. I still eat it.
I thought it was only the really cheap chocolate that did that.
No, I think
when I'd keep it in my bedroom as a kid after
I think that
East.
Starts a bit white.
Right.
That
okay.
cheap chocolate.
Yeah. You know? It doesn't taste anything like actual chocolate.
No. I don't know what they put in that stuff. No, this is proper chocolate, like your Kit Kats, your Cadbury's, and they were just basically liquid. I would pour that into a cup and drink it for them. I hope they didn't chuck it away. That would be so yummy.
I can tell you 100% that they did throw it out. There's no way. There's no way that they're going, guys, come in, free chocolate in a cup for you that you just drink.
Oh, that would be so yummy.
Woolies employees walking around just open up a packet and tipping it in mum's mouths.
Yum.
I feel like that's someone's kink somewhere. Floppy disks.
Whoa. Discs.
Oh, yeah, discs. What did I say?
Yeah.
I said it right?
Discs.
Great.
Yes.
All right.
Nope.
Dump. too late. Floppy disks. Oh, hit 104.7, Wilcon Courts, yada, yada, yada. 131060 is our number because I want to talk about old tech that you're still rocking at workplaces.
Okay.
Because there's some workplaces that refuse to update something because if they update one thing, then they have to update a bunch of other things.
Mm.
So sometimes a random bit of old tech will just still exist.
Yeah.
Like we have an older rubbish printer that if you want to print a music log out on, so let's say you're an announcer and you want to know what songs you're going to play that day and you want to print out a log, you can't print it on the good printers.
No, not the big giant ones.
No.
All of the things.
Because it's a whole separate thing.
Yeah.
The music can't be connected to any of the internet. So it's a whole separate thing.
It's just one little printer that sits in the corner.
And it never works.
One of the ones that you had in your house in the 90s.
It's terrible.
Yeah.
That's what that thing is in there.
Is that what that's for?
Yes, Hayley.
Never printed a log, obviously.
The reason I'm asking on 131060 the old tech that you're still rocking at workplaces is because the Japanese government have finally... Now, I remember bringing this story 2 years ago and saying that they were considering doing it. But they're letting go of floppy disks and CD-ROMs.
How? I don't understand. Sorry. Does that mean they've been using old computers?
Yeah.
Because that's the only way you'd be able to... Like, the computer I'm using right now, there's no
Nothing.
Space for anything.
No.
There's just, USB.
Yes,
that's it.
That's
I
it.
Don't even think...
It's USB-C, too.
I can put my headphones into this.
Nope.
You can.
Oh, there's one.
I can.
Wow, we're old school.
Wow.
There are amendments to the laws that had to be made. That's why it took so long, because physical media formats had to be the way that you submitted things to the government. So if you were running a bar and you wanted to submit a license to get like a liquor license, you had to do it on floppy disk.
But there's like, there's been USBs.
No.
Like there's, no. Why couldn't you put it on a USB?
That's a good question for the digital transformation minister, Taro Kono.
That's a job.
He announced when he took over in August 2022, when I remember talking about this, he had a war on floppy disks. Bit late to the war.
Yeah.
Because I felt like we won the war a long time ago. Who's rocket? I remember having I can't remember what the game was called, a skiing game. On floppy disk.
Oh, I remember this. On the computer.
Yeah, and yes. Then there'd be like a...
You'd have to avoid the trees and stuff. Yeah,
and there'd be like a beast at a train. But it was on floppy disk. Hayley?
We were rocking floppy disks at my old workplace. I worked at a radio station. I made ads. And some of them I would have to send to people on a floppy.
No. Yep. When was that?
Like just 3 years ago.
Wow, that's...
Put your floppy away.
That's
what I said.
No one needs... Like... Who's calling up and going, hey, can you put this on my floppy? And you're going, no.
Well, the production guy before me was...
You're not meant to have a floppy right now.
He was a little bit older. It. That has nothing to do with his floppy, but he preferred a floppy disk.
Did he?
Yeah. And I just said, I don't know how to use that.
Of course not. Because it's a floppy. Anyway, so we want to know... We've lost Sean. We want to
grow up.
I don't know why everyone's laughing.
We're talking about discs.
We're talking about technology, old technology.
He's going to lose it. You're meant to keep it together.
I am keeping it together.
You're crying. There's tears coming out of your eyes. You just told me you're just talking about a floppy disk.
I am.
A what? Are you sure?
Quickly, the last happy birthday to Harry Styles, 30th
birthday. Hope he's listening.
He didn't call in. He didn't call in. Did we send him a Zoom link?
Yeah, yeah.
But he didn't use it.
No. He's too busy. He's at the pub with his mates.
That's true. Before we wrap up this portion of the show and get into the Hit 50, I've got to tell you about, this robot. I love robots.
Oh, we know.
Have you all clocked onto that? Sammy's face is
saying yes. Do you have like a Roomba that gets around your house?
No, but I do want one.
Right.
Unfortunately, it's an expensive exercise to get the one that I want.
Right.
And no matter how much I convince Domain to give me one for free, they're just not doing it. So maybe at lunch today with them, I'll try a little bit harder.
Just start dropping some. You guys seen these Roombas?
Yeah,
you
they're got pretty them? Good. Around 2K. Got any lying around? On Saturday afternoon, they've finally gotten to the bottom of it, which is good. There's been a neighbourhood watch group who have noticed that there was an accident caused by a robot. And this is in the States. There's not a lot of... I think there's a couple of them here. They're trialling them for Australia Post.
Mm-hmm.
But have you seen these robots that just go around with a package inside them?
No.
And they go on the pathway and then they just... you're notified when it's arrived and you go out and you take the thing open.
Oh, it kind of looks like an Esky.
Yeah, it's like an Esky on wheels.
Yeah.
Which,
you know, Eskies do sometimes have wheels.
They do, and steering wheels as well, if you that into summer nats. And this particular one caused a traffic incident, a multi-car pile-up.
Oh, my gosh. Was it on the road instead of the path?
It did. It was on the road, yes. and basically, a bunch of the doors were scratched on cars and other bits. But the robot just took off.
Oh, hit and run?
Yeah.
Oh, that's hilarious.
I love it. But the best part is when the robot gets close to something where it wants to notify people that, hi, I'm here, because sometimes you're not looking down and that... Like you say, it's an Esky on wheels. Yeah. You're not always looking down. It has a little flag that comes up just to remind you that
I'm here
and it's like an orange flag. Well, the robot before the accident didn't wave its flag, but afterwards it waved its flag.
So is kind it of like sassy or is it like malfunctioning?
I don't know. It felt like a bit of a...
Middle finger.
Yes.
Yeah.
Anyway, guys, the robots have taken over.
They're just, so far I'm not too worried.
Yeah, it's one.
Yeah.
But as that Will Smith movie, I, Robot, classic movie.
Says, I loved it. Just, it starts with one. Such a good movie.
It just starts with one. So.
Yeah, I remember that so well.
You've never seen it either.
It's just, there's robots, isn't there?
Well, yeah, it's called iRobot.
Yeah.
So you would think.
Yeah, so there, I got it.
Hit 104.7's Wilco and Courts.
Barista made ice cold. Drive through for your iced coffee favourites at McCafe.